God read your mind? I love that question. This is really an interesting question in that let's look at the mind as there's a mind with a capital M, which is the mind of God, which is the divine mind, which is the mind that encompasses everything. And what that mind knows is that only love is real. So there's that mind. And then we have our mind that we come up with all kinds of things to think about and to experience here in life on earth. And that's cherished and loved by the divine, by the way, because the divine knows us with its one mind, with the capital M, as perfection. And yet, it also sees us in the form of the Holy Spirit, the holy part of us, playing around here at being separate. And it doesn't have any fear over that for us, because it's like if you were a child and your parents knew that you were going out to a playground and they saw you as going out to have fun and doing what you were going to do, and they knew you were safe and sound, no problem, and you're going to play on the playground, and did they mind if you play with a jump rope, or do they mind if you go on the jungle gym, or do they mind if you're playing hide and seek? They know you're having fun playing. And so the game you play is not really something your parents are going to obsess about. They're going to be happy for you that you're choosing to do what you want to do and having fun at it. But if you stop having fun, of course, they're going to say, look, you know, maybe you don't want to do that. That's dangerous. But they're not going to be obsessive about what you play. They want to keep you safe, and they want you to feel loved and protected, but they want you to have fun. And that's the same position that God is in, that the divine is in. It knows we're perfectly fine because there's nowhere to go. There's no such thing as death. There's no such thing as us being left or dropped. So anything we can dream up, there will be a happy ending. Even people now who are in the midst of challenges and changes physically in their bodies, that they're contending with a pandemic or they're having all kinds of things go on. In the world of the divine, this too shall pass. And our eternal nature makes these small experiences very finite and not overwhelming when we begin to identify with our vastness, when we begin to identify with the light of us. So let yourself now just relax into this space where you realize, yes, God can read your mind. Your every thought is known to the divine, but it doesn't necessarily pay attention to these thoughts that feel smaller or insignificant or challenged by life, because it knows who you truly are. The divine knows you as perfect and whole and powerful and at one with everything. So know that as the mind that you want to be connecting to when you're thinking about your own mind and identifying with that world, and you'll see yourself experiencing something a lot different than noticing if God can read your mind in this world of this and that. Everything that's ever been dreamed up by anybody in any way, shape, or form all comes back to the one purpose of bringing us back to love and divine knowledge of who we truly are as only love.